Hello viewers, we are at the mobile studio of AVIT channel at Pro AV Competence Days in Krakow 2025. And my guest is...
Hello, I'm Erik Elbert. I'm Senior Product Manager for Large Format Displays at Sharp NEC Company or Europe. We will very soon be Sharp, but that's, I think, a topic which we will discuss quite soon.
Fantastic, you are here at our mobile studio. Can we still expect new developments in large format displays beyond size and resolution? What do you think?
So what we recently did at ISE 2025, we introduced a new series or an update of the new series where we now have the full range from 32 inch up to 98 inch. Here we want to focus on the highest resolution as possible, and here we have seen that the mass market is mainly asking for UHD resolution. In the past, 2 or 3 years ago, we still had 8K. We had it in 32 inch, we also had it in 110 inch, but that one was quite a heavy and quite a complex product, where you needed to have the right content, where you needed to have the right dimensions in your meeting room. That's why we, as of today, we decided that UHD up to 98 inch is the best size for meeting room, for digital signage applications. So now we really want to focus on the best picture performance, so here high resolution with UHD, but also the best picture performance in combination with our so-called SpectraView engine that makes the pictures look as natural as possible.
And Spectra is very, very famous.
Yeah, we have it from really for a long time in desktop displays first, and then it came, it got its way into the large format displays, and yeah, we now have it also in our mainstream displays. So that's really one of the reasons why we wanted to focus on the picture performance and not on only the pixels, but really on the picture performance. So here, yeah, we want to standardize on 32 inch up to 98 inch, same mechanical design, same feature set, like metal back cover, like high haze filter, and yeah, that's really our biggest focus right now.
Yes, but should LFDs displays could be protected against potential cyber attacks, and how could be done? We know every screens today are implemented with small computers developments inside. Each brand has own developments, Sharp too.
Yeah, correct. So here, that's a perfect question, because cybersecurity, especially nowadays, we are seeing in the news always cyber attack here, cyber attack there. That's why we have different opportunities how to challenge that, how we can support our customers. On the one hand side, we have on our basic E-series lineup, so that's the essential line, we have an operating system that is completely closed. So it's completely closed, you can remotely manage these devices, but still you cannot do anything, you can't grab the video, you can't access the media player remotely. It's a very basic product, but still good for signage applications. And then on top of that, we have the Android, so we have the ME2 series, which comes with an Android system on chip, with Android operating system. And yeah, we are late to the party, but we had a reason for that, because in the past, Android was not that secure, it was not that good to be maintained from us as manufacturer. Therefore, we were waiting until Android 13 came to market. So this product was the very first one during these days when we introduced it, which was more stable, better in management, better in security. So here, our mission is we are providing over-the-air updates, and constantly we are reviewing cybersecurity features which come either from Google directly, which is the owner of the Android operating system, system. But even if Google says from one day to the other, we are not maintaining Android 13 any longer for cybersecurity, then we will be the responsible ones to fix these kind of cybersecurity or security patches. So that's our mission with Android. And when we are talking about the higher classes, higher class products like our M series or P series products, they don't have computing device integrated, because we think that the modular computing is the best, because with the modular computing, so with the slot that you slot in, the customer is in charge. We can support that with our so-called MPI4 or MPI5 kit, which is running on Raspberry Pi. There you or the system integrator or even the end user has the possibility to lock the system down and control it easily. We are supporting the highest classes like 802.1x, which is a kind of protocol or a security mechanism that only allows access to the network when the certificate is installed. That's also something which we now have integrated into the display, so only into the display to protect the communication, even without any computing mechanism. And yeah, so that's Raspberry Pi. That's also the integrated part. And on the P series level, which is meant to be installed in airports, which is a public environment, so it needs to be as secure as possible. Even there, we have mechanisms with our Intel SDM computing devices, and they run on Windows. And with Windows, we are mainly selecting the IoT channel, IoT LTSC, which stands for long-term service channel. And here, Microsoft is providing up to 10 years support for the operating system. So also here, customers can be assured that that operating system is maintained for a very long time, and that security updates, security patches are available.
They are protected. Yeah. But what is the future? You mentioned compute modules, sharp neck compute modules, now Sharp, branded by Sharp. What is the future for them? And who are the main customers for them?
Now that we are Sharp, or from 1st of November, we will be fully Sharp company. So yeah, our goal is we will be still the same people. That's the good thing. We will still be the same people, especially here in Europe. We won't change. The product management team, which goes with customer requests towards Japan, will still be the same team. But luckily, on Japan side, we now have access to way more divisions. In the past, NEC was not having that opportunity to IT services. Now with Sharp, we have that access, and by that we can even make more secure products because of this interoperability with IT services. So that's one big thing. And on the computing side, we also want to continue with Raspberry Pi. There will be at ISE, there will be some announcements. So already teasering a little bit what will come here at ISE, so please really stay tuned. Yeah, on the SDM computing device, we also are working more on the AI part in order to be more open and bring more potential of AI from security point of view, from flexibility and ease of use point of view to our products. Also same with the module slot.
And next subject is USB-C, which is very important connection. Everybody knows it, but how important is the connectivity in modern LFDs screens?
USB-C for us, I think we were one of the very first manufacturers that implemented USB Type-C into our product portfolio. And with product portfolio, I don't necessarily mean large format displays, because we had USB Type-C already in our desktop displays from 2013 19, 2018.
You were one of the first.
Yeah, so that was really, really early. And when we had a look what the colleagues from the desktop group was doing, we thought, okay, why not implementing this function into the large format displays? Because USB-C, one cable, everything goes via one cable. It simplifies meeting rooms. It simplifies people who are not that experts like we are. So people in the industry, they know.
For normal people.
Exactly. So they know what an HDMI connector is. They know what a display port is. But yeah, I always use a good example. My wife is working in a company, in a consultancy company. And she always gave me a call, which cable has to be connected where in my notebook. It was really funny. And then I told her, okay, please connect this and that and that. Or now this can be simplified. It could be simplified with just one single cable.
Just one. Every brand does it today.
On LFD side, I think not yet.
On computers, correct.
On computers. So all notebooks, all the notebooks, they have USB-C. And therefore we thought, okay, let's make first of all an expansion board, because that expansion board in SDM form factor can be integrated even in to our older displays, which we introduced in 2020. That's where we first introduced the M series and P series displays with the SDM slot. So we have here that expansion board to upgrade the display to a USB Type-C enabled device. What we now have from ISE 2025, we announced the first products with native support of USB Type-C. And here we have everything across the board. Even our lowest category, the E-Series product, is supporting USB Type-C with video. Then we have the next series, the higher series, the ME2 series, that supports video plus USB hub. So you are connecting the peripherals like your video bar, your sound bar, your webcam, you're connecting that one to it, and then it loops through the signals. And then the highest one, the M series and P series models, they have video, they have the USB hub, and also they have the full charging capabilities up to 65 watts. So we fully believe into USB Type-C, and yeah, really to simplify the use in meeting rooms. And yeah, really hopefully that becomes a big story within the next years.
With the new brand, old brand.
Yes, correct. With the new old brand, and yeah, as said,
we will. The last question is connected with the brand, with the migration from Sharp Neck to Sharp, nearly complete. You told 1st November is the first day of Sharp brand officially. Should customers in Europe expect any changes?
So far, no, because yeah, the company will still be the same. The company might have some letters less in the brand name, but yeah, the people will still be the same. We from product management will still be the same. Therefore, customers can still reach out to us if they are looking for a kind of customization, if they are looking for support. We want to, or our goal is to keep the level, the support level, the quality level on the same level like what we had before, even higher, and yeah, bringing two worlds together, bringing AV, which was the kind of NEC part, together with the IT part where Sharp has more experience. So bringing that together, and therefore yeah, everyone can be excited. We are at the moment discussing the future with Japan. That will take a little bit longer with ISE, so maybe ISE 2027 we might talk about new products. But yeah, really we have a long-term strategy, we have a long-term mission, and yeah, we are listening to the market, and yeah, we can also react to the market. That's why it's always great to be at events like this one here and listen to our customer base, which can always reach out to us.
Thank you for this inspiration interview. Thank you, Erik.
Thank you. Yeah.
My guest was Erik, and goodbye.